the luxury of introducing Heather for her HPL speech that she's going to be doing. It is out of the Advanced Communication Series, and it is the speech on accepting an award. Heather recently took on the role of doing the SAA, which is Sergeant Arms, at the HPL, at the TLI. All these acronyms, I'm just throwing them around. At the HLI, TLI, goodness, get it out, Seth. And that was what she completed in order to receive her HPL. So with this award, I would like to introduce to Heather, but the speech that she is giving, we are going to be looking for her objectives of accepting the award with dignity and grace and sincerity, and the acknowledgement of the presenting organization. So those are her objectives for today. We're looking for a speech that is 5 to 7 minutes, and then at that point, we'll go ahead and do her normal evaluation just like we would for any of the other speeches. So at this point, I'd like to introduce Heather McEnroe, HPL. HPL, Heather McEnroe.
And my mom and my doting husband. Well, mostly my doting husband. He was the one that put up with me while I worked on this award. Fellow Toastmasters, fellow area directors, and Madam Division Director. This was a little unexpected, and when I say a little, I mean I received the certificate on Saturday, and while going over, because my husband always asks me, well, why did you get this award? Going over it, it was, oh, well, that's cool. And I'm like, yeah, if only there was a speaking opportunity, I can address one of my projects. Well, somebody was listening, and I came in on Monday, and there was a speaking opportunity, to which I replied, well, if only I had $1,000. I think that request is still pending. But the high-performance leadership program plan, HPL, it helped me grow a lot within my position as a leader, and to that I must give a credit to Toastmasters. Without having performed this, I would not be the person that you have standing before you, and I definitely don't think I would have been as effective as your past president, now immediate past president, without having the opportunity to have gone through this. It was a lot of work, but through it, and through the help of other Toastmasters, I gained a better understanding of the program. Overall, Toastmasters is a place to inspire and help develop leadership and communication skills in a positive learning environment. And that's exactly what I came into. For this, for Sergeant at Arms, a lot of people don't think much of it. Sergeant at Arms, you set up the room. No, no. I have a profound appreciation for what, Robin, what you're getting into for the next 6 months, and what Mindy, who I saw a few seconds ago, what Mindy had provided for our club over the last year. And just making sure that things went without a hitch. It was a wonderful experience, and you don't realize just how much of a group and team effort it is until you are one of those links that maybe doesn't have a president or another title attached to it, but without it, there wouldn't be functional meetings, there wouldn't be functional events. So you make it or you break it. Much. Now the project says that you're not supposed to gush over anything. However, considering I say this at least on a bi-weekly basis, I have to give a shout out to you guys. Spice it up, Toastmasters. Because without you, I would not have been able to complete this. Literally, without the help of my volunteers Stephanie and Kathy, I wouldn't have even qualified for this project. So without your guys' support, and willingness to donate time, I was able to achieve something that I thought was going to take me a longer time. And I, again, not supposed to gush, but I just cannot stress how appreciative I am of it. Now, this is just one part of the many chains in Toastmasters. We have the communication side and the leadership side, and I've always needed more polish on the leadership side, as many of you have seen. But again, it comes back to you and to district leaders, where I'm getting that feedback. What can I improve on? What can I do good? So again, I must thank you and the district leaders for those little nuggets of knowledge, because every big was just one step to help me achieve my goals, to help me to become a better leader, a better communicator, and a better person overall. So thank you, that's for that. Now, there is a quote, and I know I'm so full of quotes, but I felt like this is the most fitting one. And it happened to me just yesterday, too, and I was like, perfect. The universe is sending me signs to keep going. The quote is, you don't receive what you wish for. You receive what you work hard for. So I encourage you all, please continue working hard on your projects. I'm so proud when I see them and I see you guys finish them. And also reach for every opportunity that you have. Because in this room, I see leaders, I see competent communicators, I see people that are ready to take on the world.
And sometimes they take just a little pushing, just like me.
So with that, thank you all.